We are reviewing December 2013 question number 2, Uwezo Bank, which requires us to prepare the statement of comprehensive income and the statement of financial position. So let's start by looking at the statement of comprehensive income. We know that we have to start with our interest income. And what do we have as our interest income? So we have on loans and advances by the TB 21, 231. Then you have government securities. $29.59. Then you have placements with other banks of $4.36. Now, if you review note number one, you notice that it says that the interest on loan advances of 272 has not been recorded, so you have to add 272 from note one. So it means that my total loans and advances is actually 21,503. The others have not been adjusted, so I can just post them as is. Then we come to interest expense. Under interest expense, we have customer deposits. Per the TB, it is 8,013. However, note one tells us that the interest expense accrued is 150. Gives us 8,163. Then you have placements, other banks of 297. So this gives us net interest income of how much? So let's first find the totals of the interest expense. It is 8,460. So this gives me net interest income of 16,438. So after that, we move to our next heading, which is on other income. We have fees and commissions income, which is 1455. Then you have forex income, which is 1297. Then we have fair value gains. This is from our note number two, where we are told that the financial assets are the had the book value of combined value of 30 and a fair value combined of 34. So that is from note two. Gives you 4,000. Don't have any other items, so we can sum them up even. Before we move to other operating expenses, where we are told that operating expenses are amounting to 6,118, and there is a loan impairment. The loan impairment expense we are told is 999. However, we are told in the notes, note number three, a further allowance of 40.5 is to be provided from note three. Gives me a total of 1047.5. So, can I find out now what my net profit is? Let's just do the balancing and the add. So other income is giving me 6,757 other expenses is giving me 7165.5. So this gives us a net profit of 16024. That's our statement of comprehensive income. We are now in a position to prepare the statement of financial position on the basis of liquidity. So we start with the assets. We're going to put them in order of liquidity, of reducing liquidity. So the first item is cash with CBK, which is 17,170. The next is government securities, which is 27,694. Next, we have financial assets, which are now at 34,000. This is as per the note to the question. Note 2. Then you have loans and advances, which as per the TB we have 119,200. However, there have been some few adjustments. The first one being note number 1. There is an interest that has not been recorded, so we need to add it. As well as note number 3 about an allowance, so a doubtful debt of 48.5, which needs to be removed. So this gives me loans and advances of 119,423.5. The next item is property, plant and equipment, which is 1824. Next we have intangible assets, of 388. Then you have placements with other banks, which actually should appear at the top. Because it's a bit more liquid than the others. Of 8,400. Only that we're done with the asset side. So our total assets are 215,999.5. We move on to capital and liabilities. Capital is provided as being 4,200. Then we have share premium, which is 3,580. Then retained earnings, which is 23,933, that is the opening balance, plus profits for the year, which is 16 or 24.5, which gives me 39,957.5. Then I have liabilities. Where I have borrowed funds of 4572. Then we have customer deposits, which is more liquid, so I'll put it on top. Customer deposits per the TB is 162,300. However, it has been affected by the notes. The first note that says that there is interest accrued on customer deposits not accounted for of 150. So I need to say plus 150. So that I get total amount of 162,450. Let's align these figures. Okay. The next item I have is retirement benefits. Liability, which is provided at 175. We have placements from other banks, which is more liquid, so I'll put it on top. Placements from other banks we have is 1065, and with that I'm done. Let's add them up and find out whether they will balance. And you realize that the accounts are indeed in balance. So this is what was expected of us in that exam question. Very simple, just master the formats and then get the entries.